संदीप सर, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस मैम, यू आर ऑडिबल।
संदीप सर, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस मैम, यू आर ऑडिबल।
हेलो संदीप सर, एम आई ऑडिबल? हेलो
सर, इट्स ऑडिबल?
मैम, कैन यू चेंज योर नेम? बिकॉज इट इज डिस्प्लेइंग गौरांग राठी। कनिका मैम,
या श्योर श्योर श्योर, जस्ट अ सेकेंड।
या
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस सर, यू आर ऑडिबल।
संदीप सर, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस सर, ऑडिबल।
ओके सर, थैंक यू।
नरेश सर, गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
Sandeep sir, it's okay now?
Yes, ma'am, okay.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, Sandeep sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, am I audible?
Yes, sir, audible.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Why did you do the second one?
Yes, sir, Sandeep, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you were saying, you were saying something?
No, sir, no, sir.
Okay, check.
आज हमारे एमबीए के दूसरे सेमेस्टर का वो है मीटिंग अभी चल रही है वीसी दो साल
गुड आफ्टरनून मराठे सर
गुड आफ्टरनून
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Safiya, ma'am, join.
I need to check.
Yes.
Not yet. बहुत ज़्यादा आई थिंक वी कैन स्टार्ट मैम
ओके
With the permission of Marathi, sir, can we start?
Yeah. Go ahead.
Thank you, sir. Greetings, everybody. Before we begin, I have a request to all of you. Please keep yourselves on mute. If you have a query, please raise your hand. You may write to us on the chat box. We will take all your queries, but please make sure you keep your mics on mute throughout the program. All right. Greetings, everybody. On behalf of Dr. D.Y. Patil Vidyapeeth Pune, Center for Online Learning, I, Professor Sonam Mathur, welcome you all to the induction program for Semester 2, Batch July 2020. I will be the program in charge for the batch Semester 2, 3, can continue for July 2020 batch. Okay. With my humble request, I also tell you that if you have a query, please keep your hand raised. We will try to take up your queries, but do not interrupt the program. Thank you. Also keep your mobile phones on silent. Thank you, everyone. Okay, let us begin the session. We will take you through an introduction to the online MBA program. Sandeep sir, if you could please play the video.
Based on the vision of Honorable Dr. P.D. Patil, Chancellor of D.Y. Patil University, Pune, and Mrs. Smita Sadhav, Executive Director, DPU. An MBA program is designed to develop future-focused capabilities of students. Here is your chance to be mentored by leading academicians and industry experts, and you can study in your own time, at your own pace.
I'm Dr. Safiya, Director of Center for Online Learning of Dr. D.Y. Patil University. An MBA program is designed and developed to seek out those capabilities which are required by the employer in the current scenario. First two semesters of our online MBA program are common for all the specializations. We have 8 specializations of our online MBA program, which are Human Resource Management, Financial Management, Marketing Management, Information Technology Management, International Business Management, Project Management, Operations Management, and Hospital and Healthcare Management.
Online delivery model will give you freedom to choose when, where, and how much you want to study. An MBA program will prepare you for the workplace of the future. An affordable, a world-class MBA degree now made available for all. It will force you to think critically, innovate successfully, and solve problems creatively. After completion of this online MBA, aspirants shall enhance managerial competencies to take on corporate challenges in various sectors of the Indian economic environment. This MBA program is designed by academic and industry experts with the intention of improving various skill sets of the participants. This online MBA is 2 years spread over 4 semester programs. In the 4th semester project work, they will be able to make good use of all the courses that they have learned and be able to apply it and solve the complex issues they face in the domain in which they are working. They shall come out with unique, creative, innovative, or out-of-the-box solutions in the corporate world. The program is delivered course-wise and unit-wise through a unique world-class learning management system platform. All units of all the courses are designed and delivered using 4-quadrant approaches as suggested in the UGC notification for online programs. Each unit has pre-recorded video lectures, e-text material, articles or notes, case studies, open resources, virtual class to clear doubts, FAQs, quizzes, self-assessment. Learner will be engaged continuously through learner management system features such as discussion forums, chatting, class wall, message, email, RSS feed, etc. The program is mainly for working class and is completely online mode, right from the registration for the program to getting the degree.
Visit www.dypatilonline.com.
Thank you, Sandeep sir. Okay. With this introduction video, you have seen what we'll be taking you through in the MBA program. Further, I would request Sandeep sir to play another video that will take all of you through the program structure, the credit policy that we are following, and the marking system. Sandeep sir, please.
Warm welcome to all the learners of online program. In this session, get to know your program better. I would like to help you to understand your program better. I shall cover all the necessary aspects of the program, its delivery, learners' engagement, and evaluation. The moment learners logs in, he or she will have access to all the program documents. The first thing you should know as a learner is the program educational objectives, PEOs, program outcomes, POs, and the graduate attributes, GAs. This should give you the idea about the skill sets or managerial competencies this program is preparing you for. You will learn decision making as a result of management thinking, such as strategic integrated thinking, critical and analytical thinking, innovative thinking, etc. At the end of the program, learners should be able to demonstrate the capabilities of solving the issues in a real-world situation using these competencies. The next thing learners should know is the program structure. Now let us see what information learner gets from program structure. As you know, online MBA is a 2 years spread over 4 semesters degree program. You shall get to know which courses you will learn in each of the semesters. Program structure gives you idea about the program title, like online Master of Business Administration, online MBA. And if you really look into that summary part of it, that will give you idea about in each semester how many total credits are there, total courses you will learn, and the total marks to be evaluated for that semester. Let us say semester 1 has got total of 27 credits. I will get back to that credits later on. I will explain you what credits are and its implications. Total courses, there are 7 total courses that a learner will learn, and the total marks evaluated are 650. Semester 2 has got 27 total credits, 7 total courses, and 650 total marks. Semester 3 has got 28 total credits, total courses are 7, and then 700 total marks are evaluated. Semester 4 has got 20 credits, having 3 courses, total courses, and 500 marks. So in all, you will have 102 credits and you will learn 24 courses and a project work. And the total marks spread over all this semester, all these semester, 4 semesters are 2,500. Now let us look into what do we have in each semester, which courses you are having. Now this should give you idea about the courses that you will be learning in semester 1. First title, first column will give you idea about the course code. For example, OMBC 101 means it is an online MBA core course or a management core domain or a compulsory course which you will have to learn irrespective of the specialization that you'll be selecting for semester 3 and 4. Course title is Principles and Practices of Management. That will give you idea in the column 2. Credits, 4 credits. Now this course has got 4 credits. Let us understand what do we mean by credit. 1 credit is equivalent to 15 clock hours of classroom teaching, or in other words, that much time the learner needs to learn 1 credit equivalent content. So when we have principles and practices for management of 4 credits, means learners will be engaged for about 60 hours. Next three column gives you idea about the evaluation. Now, each course, right from 101 to 106, are evaluated for 100 marks, and these 100 marks are divided into two components: formative continuous assessment of 40 marks and summative proctored assessment of 60 marks. The last row in that particular thing, OMBC 107, gives you idea about the generic core, which is a compulsory, but it is a generic, not the domain course, like environmental awareness and disaster management. This is a 3 credits course. Naturally, you will be engaged for 45 hours. And it is having only formative continuous assessment of 50 marks, and it will not have any summative or a term end exam. And it will be evaluated for 50 marks. So the total credits for this particular semester are 27 credits and evaluated for 650 marks. This is how you like to read.
Yes. Aditya.
Semester, and you will get to know which courses you will be learning in each of the semesters. Semester 2, for example, you have OMBC 201 to 206. These are again core compulsory domain courses, and all are evaluated for 100 marks, and all are having 4 credits. But the last one, OMBC 207, which is entrepreneurship development, this is a generic core course, and that is of 3 credits, and it will be evaluated for 50 marks. It is in a formative continuous assessment, and it is not having any term end exam. Now, after completion of first 2 semesters, learners will have to select one of the 8 specializations that DPUCOL is offering, like marketing management, human resource management, finance management, IT management, project management, operations management, hospital administration and healthcare management, international business management. Suppose you have selected marketing, then semester 3, you will get marketing specialization courses. OMBM means Online MBA Marketing Specialization. So right from OMBM 301 to OMBM 306, there are 6 marketing specialization courses, and all are evaluated for 100 marks, and all are 4 credits. The last one, that is OMBE 307 or 308, that is a generic elective. Now you will have to select either of this 307 or 308. And this is also 4 credits and evaluated for 100 marks. So semester 3 has got about 28 total credit points, and it is evaluated for 700 marks. Semester 4, you will have OMBM 401 and 402 are again marketing specialization courses, and OMBE 403, 404 are generic elective. So out of that 2, you will have to select one course. So here, either you will have to select 403 or 404. The last is an important thing, that is a project work. Now, as you have almost gone through the entire courses, you will have to do some work on the topic which you are selecting, and of course there will be some guidance provided to you by the course coordinators of that specialization, and this is evaluated for 200 marks and it has got 8 credit points. So in semester 4, you will have to submit the report, and that will be evaluated. There will be orals conducted. So total are 20 credits and it is evaluated for 500 marks. This is how you will have to read the project structure of all the 4 semesters. Now we'll similarly, you can see other specialization courses. Now the next thing you should know is how the program is delivered and learners are engaged. For that, you will have to get the login credentials, and you will have to go to our learning management system. So once you get into the learning management system, you will see all the course content unit wise. For example, you want to go through the semester one principles and practices of management. You will have to select that. The moment you select that, you will get the entire course structure, all aspects about the course. For example, you will see the course description, you will see the course objective, you will see the course outcome and all the unit contents. So for example, it has got 14 units. You will get all the necessary, all the unit titles, then books and references that you can refer, and who is the course coordinator, the profile of the course coordinator, all that information is now available here. And course introductory video also you can go through. That should give you, this is a recorded course introductory video. You will get brief idea about what you will learn in that course. Then let us go into the details of the course unit wise. So once you select that, you will see the, let us say unit one, there are various components of the content. For example, you have the recorded video lecture of that, then you have ebook, then you have e-learning, you have web resources, you will have case studies and summary of the things, article notes. So this is how you will get all the unit content. Successful completion of all the semester, you will get the certificate. So right from registration, program delivery, learners engagement, evaluation and certification, this entire process is online. So I welcome you once again for a unique journey of this online program. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. The video was really comprehensive, and I guess with the video, all of you have got a very clear idea of how this program is designed, how our delivery system is designed, what are the different ways in which you will be evaluated throughout the program, as well as this also talks comprehensively about the third and fourth semester courses. Moving further, let me take you through the different courses that you people will be learning in the semester two. Now, the semester two program delivery will be based upon the sessions which we people had designed for you earlier. The courses which you people will learn in this semester are human resource management, which is a 4-credit course with an assessment policy of formative and summative assessment in the ratio 40:60. Similarly, other courses, the similar type of assessment would be marketing management, OMBC 203 financial management, OMBC 204 operations management, OMBC 205 marketing information management information system, OMBC 206 strategic management and business policy, and the last course is OMBC 207, which would be a 3-credit course, and the assessment would only be based on the formative assessment. I would now request all the course coordinators to please introduce themselves. I would request Kanika ma'am to please introduce herself and both the courses which she would be taking for semester two. Kanika ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am, for giving me this opportunity. Good afternoon, Safa ma'am, Marathi sir, all my colleagues and all the learners. My name is Kanika Godani Rathi. Will be taking you through two courses. First one, OMBC 201, Human Resource Management, and second one, OMBC 207, that is Entrepreneurship Development. I'm going to brief you about both the courses. See, human resource management is what which you will able to see in all the organization. Human resource is a practice of managing people to achieve better performances. Fine. So what is the purpose of starting this particular course in your second semester? The objective of starting this course is to understand the role of human resource management in an organization, as well as we can say we'll be learning will be learning how to design human resource system in an organization. This is all about human resource management. Now, I will like to take you through the objectives of entrepreneurship development. The course code of this course is OMBC 207. See, entrepreneurship development. See, learners, maybe you'll do the you can do the business in future. So it's very important for you all to know about entrepreneurship. So the objectives of this course is to create awareness of enterprise as well as self-employment as a career option. Okay. The second one is to develop positive attribute towards innovative ideas, enterprise and self-employed. Thank you so much. I hope you're going to enjoy these courses with me. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Kanika ma'am. I would now request Vishakha ma'am to please introduce her course. Vishakha ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Good evening to everyone. I am Professor Vishakha Kuwar, and I am the course coordinator for the course management, marketing management. Okay. So in this course, the objective of this course, why it is included in your curriculum is that here you are going to familiarize with the marketing concepts, different practices in marketing, as well as here it will develop your analytical skills, your cognitive abilities, and also the substantial knowledge about the marketing. Now, we know that the marketing is an important function of any organizations because the bottom line of any business is to make money, okay? And the marketing, it is an essential channel to reach to that goal. Now, here, many creatives explain that without marketing, there is no business. So here, the marketing is ultimately which can raise the sales. So this course, it is also intended as a foundation course. Those who are planning further work in marketing, so it will give you insight to decide which one is the specialization is suitable to you in the second year. Okay. So this is about my course, that is marketing management. I will be there to solve your all queries. I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Vishakha ma'am. I request Bhuvan sir to introduce himself and his course.
Thank you, Sona ma'am. Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah. Good evening, respected Director Safia ma'am, respected Marathi sir, and my dear colleagues. I am Bhuvan Jain, a faculty of financial management course. As we understand, finance is an essential and indispensable part of an organization. So under this course, we will get an opportunity to understand how financial management helps an organization to utilize their finances most profitably. So I expect to see you all in my sessions. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Bhuvan sir. I request Vikas sir to introduce himself and his course.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Hello, Rana. Welcome you all for the second semester of online MBA. I am a course coordinator for the course OMBC 204, that is operation management. So in operation management, the objective of operation management, the first one is the customer service. The primary objective of the operation management is to utilize the resources of the organization to create a such product or the service that satisfy the needs of the customer by providing the right thing at the right place in the right time, and also other resource utilization to make the best possible use of organization resources to satisfy the wants of the customer is another important objective operation objective of the operation management. So I once again welcome you all to the second semester. Thank you
Vikas sir. I now request Vaishali ma'am to introduce herself and her course.
Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, Sona ma'am. Welcome, learners, to second semester of online MBA to D.Y. Patil Vidyapeeth Pune. I, Professor Vaishali Joshi, will take you to OMBC 205 course, that is Management Information System. as we know that in every organization, there are people, process, equipments together to sort, analyze, and evaluate the needed information accurately and timely. The information is required, and this course will teach you, you will get the knowledge of information system related to the business. The course is beautifully designed in 10 units, right from creating information, the purpose of information, up to the implementation using DBMS and all that you will learn in this course. I hope you will enjoy this course. Thank you.
Thank you, Vaishali ma'am. I now request Manushi ma'am to introduce herself and her course.
Hello everyone. Good evening to all. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, welcome to SEM2, all of my dear students. We have already had a good session on managerial economics, which I did made you learn. We did learn so many decision-making techniques, so many things in SEM1 on managerial economics. So now in this semester, I'll be making you understand on OMBC 2.06, that is strategic management. So basically, the strategic management is very essential for you guys to understand. Why? Let me tell you. See, strategies are the one which makes the business successful. If you are adopting effective strategies, this will definitely help you to formulate efficient plans, and this will help you to fight competition, which is so very cutthroat in the market. So this particular course will help you to understand so many things, so which I would like to share with you, and we'll be learning so many interesting things, so many interesting strategies, how to fight competition, the tactics, which will make the subject and the course very interesting. So welcome all of you and have a good evening. Thank you.
Rishi ma'am. So you have been taken briefly across to all the courses and all the curriculum parts that you're going to cover in the various courses designed for you in the second semester. I now open the forum for any questions that you have. I still request you, please raise your hand or write your questions to us in the chat box. We'll be taking up all your questions. Yes, please. One by one, I would request. I see Abhishek. Yes, Abhishek, please go ahead. I request all others to please be muted.
So, yes. Hi, Mamesha, Bikesh. So, I have a two question. Yes. So, one question is around, is there any plan in the future to introduce more, specialization like we currently have, I think, 4 or 5, more promising technology like in big data and similar kind of basically specialization? And second, initially during admission, I chose a project management, but I wanted to move in the information technology. So what is the process, how I can do that? Right. Thank you.
You're talking about specialization courses for the third semester, right?
Yeah. So in general, I'm talking, is there any plan in the future to add a more specialization so we can opt for that? And second, how to change a specialization? In case someone chooses, let's say, marketing and now wanted to move in the finance management, how he can do it there?
All right. As far as your second question is concerned, after you finish with your semester 2, you will have an option to choose your specialization, wherein even if you have opted for one, maybe in the beginning, you can switch to the other before you finally, enroll yourself in the third semester. So you can always do that. For your first question, where you are talking about introduction of more specializations, you are talking about big data. See,
I'm saying the one example. There are the multiples like entrepreneurship, public policy, and all those things, home business, something like that. So right. There are the multiple streams. I'm just giving one example for this big data and some other.
Okay. For this, I would like to tell you that right now we have 8 specializations, and under these 8 specializations, we have tried to cover most of the courses that can, you know, enhance the learning of the person who's taking a specialization. For entrepreneurship, we already have a course in the second semester for which Kanika ma'am is the course coordinator. I'm sure she's communicated the objective of the course to all of you. And as far as any specific specialization subject is concerned, if you have any, you know, objective of learning a particular course, you may probably write to the concerned course coordinator who can take care of, you know, incorporating certain ideas from the course in your learning.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you. Yes, Nitin, may I ask you to go ahead?
Yeah, so the question is about the study material and the, you know, online Swayam material which is available. We found that there were many mistakes, like, you know, there were many spelling mistakes, there were many mistakes of the answer checking, and we were not sure that whether our answers will get evaluated from semester one, where answers will get evaluated on the right answers or the answers which were provided in the, you know, last minute we received some workbook kind of thing. So just wanted to check how these things is going to handle on this.
Yes.
Yeah, Sona madam, can I take this?
Sure, sir.
Yeah. So, okay, and that gives me an opportunity to talk about the latest changes that we are going to do in the assessments. Okay, for the learners of all, yeah. You see, nobody's perfect in anything in the world, you know, that's very difficult to, I have perfection in everything. But I'm really thankful that a lot of learners have brought it to our notice, the errors which are there, like, you know, spelling errors or some errors, SAQs and all. And I'm really thankful to all the learners. And this is the type of feedback that we want, and definitely we'll go through such type of feedback and we correct our thing. When it was brought to our notice from your batch only, and we have made a lot of corrections, and the task was given to all the respective course coordinators to check the question bank of the entire thing, including the SAQs. Okay, so there'll be a proper thing. But what I suggest is, all these units more or less are designed very nicely as per the four quadrant approach of the UGC, and please go through that. And even in future, even in second semester, if you find such type of thing, definitely you bring it to the notice of the respective course coordinators, and I'm sure we'll get back to you on this. Okay, now regarding that evaluation part, we are making one major change in the evaluation. As you know that in the formative, as it is getting formed, that is the exact meaning of that formative. So it is, when it comes to that, the 4 credit or 3 credit, you have 10 marks of SAQ. Now SAQs are self-assessment questions, which you find at the end of each unit. At the end of each unit, you will have 10 such type of MCQs. And once you select that, you will get the feedback about the which is the correct thing. And so what we have done is, earlier we have given 10 marks for that, but now this time we have removed that from the assessment aspect of it. So out of that 40, it will be assignment 1 and 2 that only will be considered as far as evaluation is concerned. And these all SAQs as a result at the end of this unit, each unit is for you to practice. Even in that, if you find there are errors, despite our correction and all, please bring it to our notice. No problem. We'll not feel bad about it, and we are happy about it. Somebody is going into that depthness and then giving us feedback, and I really welcome it as an academician. Okay, so what we are doing now is assessment of 40 marks are having that assignment 1 at the end of the entire delivery of the thing will announce. And you will have to appear for assignment 1, which is of 30 questions and 30 marks of all MCQ or objective type, having multiple choice, single response, true, false, and fill in the blanks type of categories. And you have 30 marks evaluated for that. And then you have no change in the assignment two, in which you have 5 marks each and you have to attempt 2 out of 3 subjective type of assessment. So that 30 marks of assignment one and 10 marks of assignment two forms 40 marks as far as your 40 marks is concerned, and no change in the summative. But you know, in case of this one, as that COVID things are going on, we'll continue. I don't know today, but we may. I'm talking about you will appear for this one in the month of July for your semester end or summative assessment. So we'll see that time whether it can still be done from your own residence, the proctored based, or whether you would have to go into your nearest center and appear for that. That will let you know later on. But right now, there's no change in the summative assessment. So that holds good. So this is what I thought I should share it with all the learners of semester two, because earlier you were given that weightage of 10 marks for the SEQs. Now it is removed from that because there was a demand for such type of practice sessions. So unit end things, 10 marks for 10 units, you have 100 questions. For 15 units, you have 150 questions as a practice session. So that should help you to perform better. And still, if there are any errors and all, please feel free and bother respective course coordinators. I thank all learners for that.
Thank you so much, sir. I hope a lot of queries have been answered by sir. A lot of questions I see in the chat box were regarding the examination, assessment, etc. I think with the explanation that sir has given to all of us, a lot of your doubts have been solved. Some questions are regarding the results of your first semester. We'll be declaring the results in the next week. Your mentors will get in touch with you for anything, any doubts that you have regarding any of the assessments. For questions that you have asked is regarding choosing the specialization, dual specialization. That is what I understand. Right now, we only offer one specialization, but you always have an option of taking the third semester twice with 2 different specializations. You will also be provided a link to the recorded lectures. I would request Sandeep sir, if you could demonstrate to the learners where they would be able to access the link to the recorded lectures. Some of you have asked this query. Sandeep sir?
Yes, ma'am. I will share my screen.
Sure, sir.
Yeah. I think all can now see my screen. Now we are going to make the provision of providing recorded session, live sessions, which was taken by the faculty. So that would be available top of the units. Like if unit one is started from here, you have the tab over there, doubt clearing session. Here we will be providing all the lectures one by one. So now onwards, we are going to provide you the all sessions, recorded sessions by the faculty.
Sandeep, if I can interrupt, make it clear that suppose you have one session today.
Yeah.
Then it will be there for those who cannot attend that after 3 to 4 days. So maybe if it is Monday, then on Thursday or Friday, you will have this recorded online lecture.
Yes. After 2 or 3 days, working days, that lecture will be available here in your respective subjects, in your respective courses. So you can see in the top of the units, the link is here. So in that way, we are going to provide the links to the students. Thank you.
Thank you, Sandeep sir. I have seen a query regarding the length that you are asking regarding the answers in your assignment. Okay, as far as that question goes, you want a sample answer to understand how you can attempt your assignment too. Fine. Please get in touch with your mentor, and through your mentors, the course coordinators would be able to communicate to all of you the expected answers for the descriptive type questions, right? Yes, those who have raised hands, Zalak, yes, please go ahead.
Yeah. Good evening, ma'am. My question was, will the result be published online? Because, see, from 15th, we are starting our SEM 2. And before starting SEM 2, we really need to see how the SEM 1, you know, how we scored. And also that courier service would be like 10 days or more than that. So can we get it online? Can we request the IT team to do that?
Your result will be declared next week. You will know your result before it is, you know, mailed to all of you.
Okay, Sona madam, I have one more request for all the learners.
Yes, sir.
See, okay, you have appeared for the exam and the result will be there next week. But don't wait for the result. Immediately pay your fees, get the login credentials, because right from Monday we are starting, you know, there'll be a timetable for all the sessions. So please do not miss it. Just don't wait for, you know, getting these mark sheets and all. That will be there definitely, but don't wait for it. That is my request to all the learners. Immediately pay the fees and get the login credentials. So you will have access to all the unique contents, course-wise unique delivery, and then you can start attending right from Monday. We are conducting these sessions. We are not waiting for that result to out. It will anyway come, and all the best for your results. I'm sure you will all be, you know, you must have performed better in this. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Yes, Sujit, please go ahead with your question.
Thank you, Sonam, ma'am. So first of all, I wanted to now, as Marathi sir said, that once we pay the fees, only then we will be able to attend semester two classes, or till April 10th was the last date, I suppose, that payment for fees has to be done, right?
Yes, we would expect all the learners to pay their fee on time. Because, you know, that makes the system and the functioning very smooth.
I understand that. So I wanted to know that only payment after payment of 30,000, I will be able to attend the program from semester two, or you could say I can start with the program and by 10th of April, I need to pay my fee.
You can start, you can pay your fee and start. And the dates which have been communicated to you by your mentors would be the final dates for complete payment of your fee.
Yes. So only after payment of complete fees, I'll be able to start with semester two.
You can have an access to the sessions, but you would have limited access as far as your Swayam portal is concerned, right? So try and pay your
fee. Certainly. Honestly, we are working professionals, and this is at the month start. I hope you understand that. So in the beginning of month of April, we'll get our salaries and everything. So we'll be able to pay it off. So yeah, hence, I wanted to clarify it. So whether payment of fees is very mandatory before 15th to get the credentials, or can I start with the program and I can pay it before?
You can start with the program, but please ensure you pay before the due date.
Certainly. Thanks, Sona. My next question is, when Marathi sir clarified that there won't be any assessment for the unit assessment. So the unit assessment won't consider any marks. Post every unit does assessment of 10 questions, so that won't be considered any marks. Right. So I wanted to know that if I click on the answers, then and there, will the correct answer reflect?
Yes.
Or do I it need to...
Yes, it could exactly be the same. You can see your correct answers with the explanation.
No, earlier it was not. So I hope we all know that the answers got uploaded a week or 2 weeks before the exams. It was not then and there.
We are making necessary changes. The moment this unit online classes starts, you know, immediately we'll be releasing that unit SAQs.
Okay. No, sir. I actually wanted to know that if I click the answer and if it's a wrong answer, will the correct answer get reflected then?
Yeah, bring it to our notice. If we really find that coordinator and the team will be there, you know, of professors and even available. So,
Marathi, I'm sorry to interrupt you. I'm not saying that the answer would be wrong from your side, What I'm trying to say is that if there's a question and if I select an incorrect answer, I select an incorrect answer, will the...
Yes, Sujit, I want to answer a question. Yes, you can see the answer, correct answer of the question along with the feedback right now. Because previously we are having the marks for the this entire assessment. Right now we don't have any marks, and for that we are having last date of that. So there is no last date of this time, maybe last date, but you are able to see the right answer along with the feedback.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. One final thing. As a feedback or as you're making a system changes right now, I wanted to know or I wanted to bring to your notice that it would be really great if we can download all these questions at one stretch. So all these unit questions, because these are very important at the last exam, what we do for semester two exam. So these would come in handy for us. So can you or can we get a feature wherein we can download all these questions and the answers of what we had given in the unit?
We will try to incorporate your suggestion, Siti. All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Yeah. Hello, ma'am. I got some questions.
Yes, Ashutosh. Yes. Please go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. For working professional, we got some problem. Like, ma'am, the exam were like regular on Monday or Tuesday, Wednesday. Exam were conducted like that only. But ma'am, other universities were allowing to appear for the examination only on Mondays, only on Sunday. Sorry. So, like that, is it possible for us to, in the second semester, to appear?
See, Ashutosh, you might be aware, this year we had faced a challenge. I mean, not only us, it was a global challenge. We'd all faced the COVID situation because of which, you know, we were able to provide a lot of flexibility for examination. But due to COVID this year, we couldn't provide you the same flexibility. So, you know, considering the situation, we were forced to conduct the examination the way they were conducted. But this year, hopefully, the situation would be in favor and we would be able to, you know, accommodate most of your requests. Let us be very hopeful that this year we would be able to accommodate most of your requests.
Yeah, okay. But that created lots of problems because six to 7 days we have to take leave for that.
I understand. In fact, a lot of you wrote to me. I was the program in charge. I've been reading each and every mail you people write to us. But somehow, please understand the situation we were facing. Most of our centers were not allowed to conduct the examination because of the lockdowns and other restrictions. But this year, we are very hopeful that we would be able to provide you with the flexibility that you people look for. I hope that solves your...
Yeah.
Hello.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Hello. This is Jignesh.
Yes.
I have one question related to exam timing. If there is a possibility to flexible the timing for the individual candidate, because sometimes what happened, we have to take a leave for continuous days, and sometimes there's important meetings in company. So we can choose our timing according to the flexibility and suggest two timing, one with anyone, either or we can provide the exam.
Right. Like I just told, we try to give you the maximum flexibility that we can. But, this year we are very hopeful that based on all your suggestions, your requests that we have received in the previous semester, we have tried to incorporate a few changes, like sir already communicated to you for the formative assessment. For the summative assessments, yes, we hope to provide you more flexibility. Let us be very hopeful of a positive situation this year, and then maybe we can take up most of your requests.
Thank you.
Yes,
madam, I have one question. Amit is this side.
Yes, Amit.
I have one question. Whatever your question and answer sessions timing, because your timing is about 4:30 p.m. and that time we are working, so we can't able to attend that sessions. So is there any possibility to change the time?
Amit, if you saw Sandeep sir's video right now, he shared with all of you, we would be uploading all the discussion sessions online for all of your reference. In case you missed the session during those hours, you may refer to the uploaded session. And if you still face any issue with any of the topics, you may write it to your mentors or your coordinators. The course coordinators can then take up your doubts accordingly. So this time, please see all the recordings that we'll be uploading for the sessions for your reference.
Okay, madam. Thanks.
Yes,
ma'am, this is Dhwani. I have few concerns to ask you. May I?
Yes, please go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. Firstly, as it's already discussed, if the exam timings would be flexible, it becomes very easy for working professionals like us, so that at least we can attend our office and then it, we could give. The another request I would like to make here is that if we could get the assignments bit earlier, like during the starting of the semester, it becomes easy for us to refer the material and submit the assignments also. Last semester also I faced few problems regarding the same. So
yes, Vani.
It would be better if that happens this way. The thing I would like to address here is that I faced a few problems during the examination and course that mentors are not available. I understand that there are plenty of students like us calling them constantly. So it becomes easy if you provide us the mentors for the group of students. Like if we can have two or three mentors during the course, it becomes easy for us to coordinate. And I think they'll also be quite more available. So these are the few concerns I have, if you could consider them.
Chaudhwani,
okay. Yeah, Sona madam, just one point I would like to add. A lot of questions are regarding flexibility and all. Thanks. Actually, when we designed the entire program, we had a lot of such type of flexibility, even different time slots in the examination. You know, somehow earlier we could not implement that, but then we are talking with the DPU examination controller of examination of the university, and we are trying to convince them that in this online we need to have the flexibility so that all these people are working class and they can so that can be done
exactly, sir, because as we are working professionals today,
and we'll let us hope by June, July, we'll announce through that Swayam platform through mentors. And as you said that for already there are about for 250 learners, there are mentors. Now that, okay, we are having, your class is the biggest class ever. So with your request, maybe we'll have more this one mentors, okay?
Thank you, sir. Last two questions.
Hello, I'm Dr. Kaushik, ma'am.
Yes.
It was nice giving exams, ma'am, last time, because you people did it in online, and we are very happy because we could not come out there and all. It was very fantastic, ma'am. This year also we expect the same, and flexibility as Sir also discussed with it. And thank you, ma'am. One more thing. I just want some real-time problem-based discussions in the theory sessions.
Right.
Like what we face in the industry. Suppose I opted healthcare management. So like that, if it is now second semester going to HR and all these things. So what are the real-time, real problems they face in the industry? So those examples should be increased in the theory parts, as that it will be like practical-oriented. Rather than just reading the book and all.
Like to request you all, you have case studies in all the courses in each unit, right? I request all of you, please read those cases before you come for the discussion forum, because you know a lot of times the industry examples are very well written in those cases, but just because you know you tend to miss reading them before the sessions, there might not be a lot of discussions happening in those sense. But then, please make sure you read the cases before you come for the sessions. The course coordinators would also then be, you know, more than happy into sharing more industry and live examples based on the case studies that we have uploaded on the Swayam portal for each unit in each course.
Okay. And my humble request is, please make sure that professors pay more attention on practical oriented things rather than explaining ABC basics, because that's it, nothing more than that. Of course, they have done excellent in first semester, but a little more if they are more practical, because you have seen since 1 year, it is more practical nowadays going after COVID. So we want it to be like that classes. Yeah, thank you.
I would now take last two questions. If your questions are not regarding the same queries we have already solved, please bring them up.
Ma'am, I actually had a question. I wanted to know, since in between you had said that in semester three, we can take it twice for two different majors. Can we do the same for semester four? And will we be getting two certifications in that case?
You cannot do it simultaneously, but yes, you can take up one specialization in one go, then you will opt for another specialization in go, and then obviously you will have two different certificates if you opt for two different specializations.
So when we opt for the second specialization, do we have to continue with like the same as in the first year, first semester, second semester, or do we start from third semester itself?
Okay. Sonam, can I take that? Okay. See, it is this particular aspect about the dual specialization is also under consideration, and we are requesting university to allow that. For example, you are having semester three generic elective core, generic courses. So that, and if you really look into the specialization, you have six in semester three and two in semester four, right? So you can repeat one additional year by paying additional fees. Though those details we have to work out yet. And I think by the time you are through with this semester two, I think university will be ready for offering such type of things. So you don't have to repeat semester one and two. You have to repeat only specialization courses in the next additional year of eight specialization courses. Suppose you are through with one HR, and now you want to do IT. So you have to take only IT courses. You don't have to repeat, because same credit will be transferred to your second specialization as well. As far as 307 and 307 or 308, which you have selected as a elective. Okay, have I solved your query?
So will we get two certificates, or will we get two subjects in the result after that if we pursue both of the
two certificates? Yes, you will get two certificates.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
All right. Okay. Any?
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, ma'am. I have one question. I am Sanchit.
Yes.
My question is, after completion of suppose this semester, will we be getting the mark sheets online or offline mode?
After completion of semester two or semester one?
Means after every semester completion, I am asking.
You will get your mark sheet in both the modes.
So it will be like given on our home address, right?
For that, yes, you may get in touch with your mentor, who can very specifically tell you regarding the same. But you will get your mark sheets. Be rest assured.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Yes.
Just one question. Hello?
Yes.
I wanted to find out if there is an online library that is customized from the school, because I've seen that we may need also to do some leaflets checking of some sort. So I was wondering if there is that possibility of having an online customized library under DPU.
Yeah, I read one of the learner asking the same question, and I appreciate the fact that you people, are genuinely interested into researching and verifying with content. We will surely accommodate your request, and that would, be a very good learning platform, not only for the learners, but I guess for each one of us who's a part of this meeting. Thank you for bringing this point up, Kelvin. We'll surely look into this. Yes.
Hello, ma'am. My name is Fazal. So the query is regarding the 80-KT part. And secondly, I would like to ask, when will be this complete semester, like complete our course will end? In which year? Because we have already, I think, from June, we took the admission. We are now going for a second semester, which will be coming in March. And then it may end around November, something like that. So we'll be taking 2 years right now over our course and over our, schedule of MBA. So I think in 2 years, we should be completing our complete MBA. That was my thinking. Is that correct? Can you just please clarify on that?
Yes, Fazal. You are aware, like I, you know, just discussed a few moments back that we were facing a challenge because of which, you know, the admissions, everything were a bit, you know, challenging in terms, not in terms of, you know, accommodating, but yes, in terms of taking the programs on time. And because of those changes in the policy by UGC, etc., there were certain delays. But be rest assured, we will be completing your program in 2 years. It's a 2-year program, obviously. So we will finish it in 2 years. And whatever lags are there, we will try to cover them up.
And Katie, just for a note.
Okay, Sonam, can I?
Yeah.
As you said that, okay, there is definitely a delay. For example, this by July, you will be through with this second semester, okay, which you are supposed to finish by June. So hardly we are delaying this one by 1 or 2 months. What we are planning is your semester 3 will immediately start in the month of August. This is what we are planning. So that by June, see, you people are July 2020 batch, right? So you are supposed to through with all the 4 semester by 22 July, right? 20,
yes,
you have started. So by next year, you will be by summer, you will be through with your semester 4. And as far as ATKT things are concerned, yeah, irrespective of your result, you will be promoted automatically for the subsequent thing. And not only that, UGC allows you to complete the 2 years program in 4 years. That is what, you can extend. Then if needed, you get in touch with us. We'll provide you necessary unit components also, course components also.
One last thing I would request Marathi sir to throw light on, the learners regarding placements. Sir, if you could guide them one last time regarding the placements, they need to, you know, understand if we would be assisting in the same.
Yeah. In fact, a lot of such queries have already come from the semester, those who are doing semester 3, right from March 15. We are going to start it, you know, this particular activity, and I myself am trying to design a program called as pre-placement preparation, triple P, in which you will definitely, there will be guidance from our side in how best you can prepare yourself for the employment. In existing thing, how best you can get the promotion, that you know better. But suppose if you want to diversify into some other, or to try for a other job, then we'll see how best we can do that. We are planning, there are 3 levels, how best we can prepare you for that. We are a bit serious about it, and we are very soon starting such type of activities in our CON, DPU.
Thank you, Marathi.
Hello.
So, sir,
hello?
Will DPU be providing placement opportunities to us?
Hello.
What was the question?
Ma'am,
sir, my question here is that will DPU provide us the opportunity to appear in the interview? Will you be providing the placement at the end of post semester?
I am talking about preparing you for the placements. Okay. But then we'll definitely see. Lot of our alumni, we see this particular program which we are having is there right from 10 years, I think more than 10 years. So definitely we have got a good alumni base, and I'm trying to link all alumni with your batch so that you can get opportunity, and definitely there'll be some placement opportunities also. But right now I cannot give assurance, but what I assure you is to prepare you for the placements, means to by conducting some mock interviews and such type of things in as an HR round, as well as in specialization, wherein you will get good practice from our side.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, requesting you to kindly continue with home proctored examination, sir.
Yeah, we are going to do that. Okay, anyway, we'll see.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
There is no COVID, how best we can do that, we'll explore that possibility also.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, for your
ma'am,
Yes.
Ma'am, can you explain once more that how can we do two specialization in one go?
Okay.
In one go, no way.
No way, you cannot.
Okay, or else, or like
another year you have to. Another year you have to spend. For example,
well, that's really the thing. Like we have to spend only 1 year or 2 years.
No, 2 years for one specialization. But if you want another specialization, you have to spend one more year.
Only one more year, right?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Means in 3 years you may get this double second specialization.
Okay, sir. No problem.
Okay. One last time, I'll tell you all. You will have your examination results rolled out next week, right? Okay. If there's
so, will they be mailed next week, or will they be mailed after some time?
Yes. Yes. Next week we'll be giving you your results. One last question. Yes, please go ahead. The last.
Yeah, ma'am. But ma'am, at the time of admission, we have that there is going to be certain job opportunities also. So,
sir, like, told you that we are exploring the possibilities right now, and through your mentors, we'll be communicating you the same as and when we are looking. For now, even if you're talking about placement, that becomes a concern once you're in the third semester. So for the second semester,
ma'am, excuse me, sorry to say, I am a little bit late to join in the Zoom meeting. One question is that regarding the dual specialization. When we supposed to join for the dual specialization?
There's no dual specialization as of now. Since you joined late, you might not be aware. We only right now have 8 specializations, none of which is a dual specialization.
Okay.
Dual specialization, sir just informed you that you can take up one in one go and maybe another in the second go. That means in doing one in the 2 year program and then another with one more year of learning with us.
Sorry to interrupt you. That's what I am asking. After completing the 2 years course, can join in the dual specialization or before the completion of course?
No, after the completion of a 2 year course, only you can take up another specialization.
Okay, right. Thank you very much.
Thank you, everybody. I would now request Bhuvan sir to propose the word of thanks. Bhuvan sir.
Yeah, thank you so much, Sonam ma'am. Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I express deep gratitude to respected Director Safia ma'am for always being a guiding light to all of us. Extremely grateful to respected Professor Marathe sir for motivating and imparting valuable advice to all of us and solving learners' queries. Much obliged to Professor Sonam ma'am for smooth hosting and conducting an induction program for our semester 2 learners. Ever thankful to our technical team, Sandeep sir, Uday sir, for ensuring an uninterrupted session. Many thanks to our course coordinators for taking learners through respective courses, and truly appreciate our mentors for constantly engaging learners and promptly resolving their queries. And in the end, we are highly obliged to our dear learners for participating in the induction program. And I hope the session was fruitful and informative and you got a chance to ask all your questions. Thank you very much for the program. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Bhuvan sir. Thank you, Safia ma'am. Thank you, Marathe sir, for being a part of the program. Thank you all the learners for joining the program. I now formally announce